Hello and welcome to the session. In this session, we will describe association between two variables using scatter plots. Or we can say, here we will describe association in a bivariate data using scatter plots. Now, a bivariate data involves two variables say x and y, and now we will see association between these two variables, that is between x and y. Now let us see what is a scatter plot. Now, a scatter plot is a graph that shows a relationship between two data sets, and these two data sets are graphed as ordered pair in the coordinate plane. Now, let us see one example. Here we have data of the two variables x and y. Now, we can plot them as the ordered pair x, y in the coordinate plane. First of all, let us plot the ordered pair 4, 10 on the graph. Now here, this is the point whose x coordinate is 4 and y coordinate is 10. Similarly, we can plot the other points also, and this graph in which we have plotted all these points is called the scatter plot. And now let us discuss association between two variables. Now often we wish to know how variables are associated or related. To find such a relationship, we construct and observe a scatter plot. Now, a scatter plot consists of points plotted on a set of axes, and in a scatter plot, the independent variable is placed on the horizontal axis and dependent variable is placed on the vertical axis. Now, there are three types of relationships. First is positive relationship. Second is negative relationship. And third is no relationship. Now, for positive relationship, we look at the pattern of scatter plot. If it is moving upwards, then there is a positive relationship between two variables x and y, and it exists when dependent variable y increases with the increase in independent variable x. For example, we have a relationship between weight and height in this scatter plot. Here, weight depends on height. When height increases, weight also increases. Here, you can see the pattern of dots. They are moving upwards, so there is a positive association between height and weight. Now, let us see negative relationship. For this, again, we look at the pattern of scatter plot. If it is moving downwards, then there is a negative relationship between two variables x and y. And this exists when dependent variable y decreases with an increase in the independent variable x. For example, we have a relationship between students per computer and years. Now here you can see, with each passing year, number of computers increase. So, the number of students using one computer decreased. Now, in the year 1987, there were 35 students per computer, and in the year 1999, it was reduced to 5. So here, the graph is moving downwards. So there is a negative relationship. Now, look at this pattern of scatter plot. Now this pattern is neither moving upwards nor downwards, but the points are placed randomly on the plane, or we can say they are scattered all over. So, we can say there exists no relationship between the two variables x and y, or there is no association between the two variables x and y. For example, let us see the relationship between intelligence quotient, that is IQ, and weight of students. Now from this scatter plot you can see that there is no association between IQ and weight of students, or you can say that there is no relationship between IQ and weight of students, as in this scattered plot the dots are scattered all over the graph, which means there is no relationship between the two variables. So this type of scattered plot means that there is no association between the two variables. And now let us discuss degree of association. Now we look at the spread of points to make judgment about the strength of relationship. Now by degree of relationship, we mean strength of relationship. Now, the strength can be strong, moderate, weak, and zero. Now see the following scatter plots. Now when degree of association is strong, then the dots on the scattered plot are very close to each other. Now in figure 1 you can see that the dots on the scattered plot are very close to each other. Also, here the points are moving upwards, which show positive relationship between x and y. So, as the dots are very close to each other and they are moving upwards, so here the degree of relationship is strong and this relationship is a strong positive relationship. Now in the second figure you can see the points are neither close nor too far. So here, the degree of association is moderate. Also, the points are moving upwards, so it is a moderate positive relationship. Now let us see the third scattered plot. Now when degree of association is weak, then the dots are far away from each other. So here, the points are moving upwards, but they are very far away from each other. So it is a weak positive relationship. And when we have zero strength, that is, when degree of association is zero, then it means there is no relationship between two variables. Now here, in the fourth scattered plot, the points are scattered all over, which means there is no relationship between the two variables. So here, degree of association is zero. Similarly, we have strong negative relationship, moderate negative relationship, and weak negative relationship. So in this session, we have described association between two variables using scatter plots. And this completes our session. Hope you all have enjoyed the session.